Hi, this is Julie Harland, and I'm your math gal. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you could search for any of my videos organized by topic. This is part four of synthetic division, and we do the following problem and check our answer on this video. This is synthetic division part three. We're going to do this division problem using synthetic division and then check our answer. All right, so how do we start this? Well, I first want to make sure I could use synthetic division. So I have a linear factor that I'm dividing by x plus 2, so that's fine. Remember, you can't be dividing by x squared plus 2 or something like that. So we can go ahead and take the x plus 2, equal it to 0, and solve, and that tells us what number to put in the little box. Now, the next thing is to put the coefficients in order from the highest the coefficient of the term with the highest exponent first. So I need to put this in order. So I see that the highest exponent is 3, so I've got to start out with the x cubed term. So I'm going to rewrite this as negative 2x cubed. Now I'm looking for the x squared term. There is no x squared term. So I need to write 0 in for the coefficient for the x squared term. Then I'm looking for the x term. That's 3x. And then I'm looking for the constant is 5. Keep in mind if the highest degree is 3, the highest exponent is 3, there will be 4 terms, one for each of the x terms and one for the constant. And then I need to write these in order. So now over here, the order I write the coefficients will be negative 2, 0, 3, and 5. All right. Remember, we do our little box down here, that'll be our remainder. Okay, step 1. Take the first coefficient in here and just bring it down. So we just bring that negative 2 right on down and multiply it by what's in the box and put it up at the next line under the next coefficient. So negative 2 times negative 2 is plus 4. And I add 0 plus 4 is 4. 4 times negative 2 is negative 8. That goes up here, right? You multiply what's in the box and put it at the next line under the next coefficient. So 3 minus 8 is negative 5. And you take this number and multiply by what's in the box. Negative 5 times negative 2 is 10. And I add, and whatever ends up in the box, that is my remainder. So here are the coefficients for my quotient, and that'll be my remainder. Remember, if that's the constant, that's the x term, that's the x squared term. So we're starting off with the x squared term, negative 2x squared. Plus 4x minus 5 plus, remember you write the remainder, which is 15 over what you divided by. That's what you divided by, x plus 2. If you go back and look at what happens when you do long division, you might figure out why this works. But it's a pretty nifty little way of doing long division, but you know, it only works in specific cases, for instance, linear factors. Okay, now we want to check our answer. So how do we check? We have to take our quotient, this negative 2x squared plus 4x minus 5, and multiply by what we divided by. And actually, down here is what we divided by, right? When you write the remainder, what you're dividing by is in the bottom of this fraction in the denominator. So to check, you could actually just look at your answer here to figure out you're going to do the x plus 2 times the quotient. And it doesn't matter which you put first, the quotient or the x plus 2. I'm going to write it like this. All right, we're going to have to multiply those together and then add the remainder. Okay, now you could use any method you want for multiplying negative 2x squared plus 4x minus 5 times x plus 2. I'm going to use a little box method. So I'm putting the, negative 2x squared plus plus 4x, negative 5 times x plus 2, and then I multiply. Negative 2x squared times x, it's negative 2x cubed, x times 4x plus 4x squared, negative 5 times x is negative 5x, negative 5 times 2 is negative 10. It doesn't matter what order you fill in all these blanks here, all the boxes. 4x times 2 is plus 8x, and 2 times negative 2x squared is negative 4x squared. And these are the six terms I would get if I multiplied this out some other way. And then we want to add all the like terms of what's in the box. So there's only one term that has a x cubed in it, so that's, I'm going to write that first, negative 2x cubed. And for the x squared terms, I've got a 4x squared and a minus 4x squared, so that's 0, so I have to write that down. And for the x term, I've got a plus 8x and a minus 5x, which is a plus 3x. And for the constant, I have negative 10. All right, so that's what I get when I multiply those together. But then we have to remember to add on our remainder over here of 15. So that gives me negative 2x cubed minus 3x plus 5. And if that's what we divided by, then our check works. So negative 2x cubed minus 3x plus 5 was right here. See that minus 2x cubed plus 3x plus 5. So it all checked out. And that is our answer. Negative 2x squared plus 4x minus 5 plus 15 over x plus 2. Now, I'm quite aware that most students never want to check their work, but that's the only way you know whether you got the right answer. So if you are taking a test and you have time, you should definitely check. Because if it doesn't work out, then you could go back and do the division again. You could also do long division just for practice and see if you get the same answer. Okay, on the next video, I'm going to show you what to do if you don't have a simple linear factor like x plus 2, but if you have something, let's say, like 3x plus 2, that complicates it a little bit, but if you're interested, see the next video on synthetic division. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you can view all of my videos, which are organized by topic.